This video will cover how to set up and use trust accounting in QuickBooks Online. This is the hard way, without LeanLaw. I'm going to cover five areas: chart of accounts, deposits, creating invoices, paying invoices, and trust account statements. First is the chart of accounts. I have a sample account here. We can see two bank accounts, my operating account or checking account, and then I have my IOLTA bank account where I keep my client trust money. It's marked as a detail type trust account. That's important. So that's our starting point, two bank accounts. To prepare QuickBooks for trust accounting, we need to create the liability account. That's detailed trust account liabilities that we'll call funds held in trust. This liability account here balances out the bank account, and they always need to be in balance. But we use the liability account to keep track of to which client we owe which money. So that's the chart of accounts. Next, we'll go over how to record a trust deposit. The first thing is to add a client. There it is, our sample client. The temptation here is to do a receive payment or maybe a credit memo, but that is not the way to do it. What we have to do is first prepare the chart of accounts so that there's a sub-account under funds held in trust for that client. So what we're going to do is create another liability account with the detail type of trust account liabilities. We'll name it for the client, sample client, and then the key thing is making it a sub-account under the funds held in trust liability account. We see here that we have a sub-account, and as we take money from the clients, sub-accounts will appear under the funds held in trust, and we can immediately see how much money out of the bank account we account for which client. So that's preparing us for receiving a retainer from that client. Next, we create a deposit. And this will be a deposit into the IOLTA or trust account. And then we say that it's received from our sample client. And this is the key thing here. The account for this deposit line item needs to be the sub-account under the sub-liability account that we just created. This is absolutely key to keep track of the money correctly. So we set that here. We say received retainer. Say it was a check in the amount of $5,000. Press save. All right, now we can see here in our chart of accounts that we have $5,000 in our bank account and that we show $5,000 under the sample client. So it means that they have $5,000 in our trust account. Let's quickly create another client, and then we'll create an account for them under the liability account. Sub-account of funds held in trust. Save. Now let's clear another deposit, and for this client, we now set the account to their account under funds held in trust. It's another retainer. Let's say we got $2,000 from these guys. And now let's look here. We have a clear picture of the trust account. $7,000 total. $2,000 from the other client and $5,000 from the sample client. You still with me? Next is invoices. Let's create an invoice from one of the clients. Our first one, new transaction invoice, and we create some work and we have $2,000 worth of work. Now we have $5,000 in the trust account, but it doesn't show up here. So I create the invoice here, and now we have an invoice of $2,000 for this client, and his balance is $2,000 owed. In QuickBooks, you really can't see in the right places here what the balance is. To see the balance of the trust account, you have to go over to the accounting tab and see that he has $5,000 available. So I might want to put that on the invoice. The only option really is to use the memo field down here to say something like current retainer balance $5,000, balance after invoice payment $3,000. So we sort of put that into the memo field, what we want to communicate to the client in terms of how this should be paid. This essentially becomes a notice that we're going to be paying this through the trust account. You will need to manually update the memo field to correctly reflect what the trust account balance is. Next is payment. So how do we pay the invoice? There's an open invoice here for $2,000, and I want to pay it through the trust. We do a check where we pick the client here, sample client, and we pick the IOLTA account as the bank account, and then we add a line item here where we reference the liability account for that client here and say payment of invoice. $2,000, client, sample client, and done. And then the second step we need to do is record a payment of the invoice. So we say, for example, check, payment invoice $2,000, save. Let's look at what that did in terms of our balances. Now the sample client here, his account balance is zero. And when you go to the chart of accounts, the IOLTA bank account balance is $6,000 and the operating account balance is $2,000. We transfer $2,000 essentially from the trust account to our operating account. So now it's our money essentially. On the liability side, we now see that the client's liability is down to $3,000. So he has $3,000 left that we're holding in trust for this one. It's all accurate. The key thing is to have those two transactions go in, and then also we need to then transfer the money from our bank account. So that's a payment. It's two transactions. The final step is trust statements. At any moment, you have to be audit ready. That includes always being able to account for the money in the trust account and giving detailed statements of transactions for each client. If you want to see the summary of all client balances for your trust account, you can click the chart of accounts showing a list of liability subaccounts. And if you want to see the detailed transactions for a specific client or matter, you just click on their liability account. Now, there are some rules that differ by state with regard to how money is received. It's important to go over these rules with your accountant or bookkeeper, and that's trust accounting in QuickBooks Online without the help of LeanLaw.